So next, Alex will play two great pieces of the classical guitar repertoire. Villa-Lobos wrote a series of preludes and etudes in the early part of the 20th century. Brazilian guitarist composer that wrote for Segovia and contemporaries of his. And the second piece, Leyenda, by Albanes. The interesting thing about that, Albanes is a virtuoso, was a virtuoso pianist and a wonderful composer that never wrote any music for the guitar. But much of it, the majority of it, is played on the guitar. This piece in particular is played more on the guitar than the solo piano, which is what he wrote it for. And that's mainly because he drew from a lot of Spanish folk flamenco influences, and the guitar is so inherent in that sound when he's writing for the piano or other instruments, he's always working that sound of the Spanish classical guitar. Thank you. For his set, first one by Aguado. Aguado, Fernando Sor, two Spanish guitarists, and Giuliani, an Italian guitarist. These were at the forefront of what is now considered the modern classical guitar. This was the era that this instrument developed, and they were at the forefront of developing the techniques that we still use today. Turega, the next generation, moves the ball a little further. And then the last piece of this set, Julian Lage, is a very interesting, virtuosic jazz guitarist, not a conventional jazz guitarist, that does interesting things beyond the standard jazz repertoire. And this is a piece of his that he'll play that blends different styles, including classical technique.
Thank you. weather.
Thank you.
James has set, we'll hear another piece by Aguirreta. And then an interesting arrangement of I Wish I Knew How It Would Feel to Be Free. This was a piece written by Billy Taylor, first as an instrumental with gospel influences. Later, lyrics were added by Dick Dallas and became an anthem for the civil rights movement. So James has made a very interesting arrangement of this. James is from Puerto Rico, and he put the first verse in Spanish and a more folksy sound arrangement that flows into the more modern gospel sounding piece that it is. And then followed by a piece by Leo Brower, perhaps the most prolific composer of classical guitar music of all time, Cuban composer, and still alive and writing great music that also draws on a lot of Afro-Cuban influences from his native country. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming out this evening. And I think by the time the concert ends, the weather should be better. So I think I'm not hearing the thunder outside any longer. We're going to end with two pieces. Song for My Father is a modal jazz piece from the 60s. And we'll play it in a traditional jazz way in that we'll read it from a lead sheet and we'll do some ad-libbing with the chord changes and some improvisation. And then we'll end with a trio by the great Baroque composer Vivaldi, a piece that was originally written for two mandolins in continuo. So two mandolins have been transcribed for the two guitars, James and Connor, and I will play the continuing part.